We'll start in 1 minute. Later, there's also join. I think everyone now is getting what I'm saying. From the graph, we can say three zeros, and three zeros are for this one, for first case. For this graph, we can see easily the value of zeros, minus two, values of zero will be minus two comma zero comma two for this graph, and for this one, zeros will be, from the graph we can say two zeros, but actually roots are, roots will be zero comma zero comma one because we have this equation, and from this equation we can say x square term is here, so x square equal to zero, we can say x into x will be zero, x into x, so x zero comma zero. And from this x minus 1, we get one value, 1. So basically, 3 roots will be there because degree is 3, maximum power of x is 3. Correct. So answer will be, so in book, what is the answer? 2 zeros only, because based on the graph only, we have to write the value of zeros. Based on the graph only, we have to write the values of 0. Or we can also say different zeros means we can also assume different values of x. So here we can see, 0 comma 0 comma 1 is there, so different values are 0 and 1. So basically, two zeros we can say. Here, different value is only 1, 0, 0, 0 is there, so we can say only 1, 0. That is at x equal to 0. But total values will be 3, total number of roots will be 3 based on degree of polynomial, that is degree is 3, that's why. Now, we'll see some more cases. Okay, please answer this quickly. All of you can answer this very easy. For first one, how many zeros?
One.
One. Directly you can speak, no problem. Directly we can write the values one because this is the zeros value. It is cutting. So zeros value will be at x equal to minus one and number of zeros will be one, correct? This one? Two.
That one, two.
Two, because this is 1 point and this is 1 point, right? Similarly for this also, easily we can find the values. How many zeros are there for this one?
Three,
right, correct. Three because three. At this point and this one, correct. We can easily, if proper graph we have, no, we can write the values also, zeros values, means x values. But here only we have to say, how many zeros are there? So based on the graph, you can say how, at which places it is cutting x-axis. How many zeros are there for this one?
One, sir.
Right. Because this is only straight line. In a straight line, we have only one zero because degree is one, right? N0 is steep, person, everyone is correct. This one, again?
One.
Right.
One, sir.
One. Correct. One. Last one, this one graph?
Four.
Four. Okay, one, two, three, right is four. So this is four. We got all the answers and everyone is correct. Next one, next graph, some graphs are there in exercise. So we'll see solve in again. Six questions are there in 1 minute. We'll solve. How many zeros are there for this one?
Sir, zero. No zero.
No zero.
Zero, sir.
Zero.
Zero, sir.
Zeros are basically zero.
Zero.
No zero. Correct. Anyone having difficulty, then they can write directly to me. IDK means I don't know. You should write IDK in chat. Second one. For this one?
One, sir.
Correct. One. Right. Only one. Positions also we can plot. Then this one, for this one. Third one. Third one.
Two.
Three, sir.
Third one, three.
Three,
one.
Sir.
Correct.
Three.
One.
Three, sir.
Two, three.
Two, two.
Why two?
Three, sir.
Fourth one, two, sir.
Achha,
fourth one, two.
Right, three. But at three positions, the graph is cutting this x-axis. Okay, fourth one, two. These are
two
positions.
Fifth one, four.
Okay, fine.
Eight.
This is one.
Sixth one, three.
Three, four.
Four.
This is four. This is two. This one,
yeah. Four.
Fifth one, three.
Two, three, no? Right, fifth one, four? 613 because we
613 sir
613
sir 314 correct correct this all of you are correct because we can easily plot the values also where the graph is cutting the x axis right suppose we have graph like this let me give you some cases suppose this is the graph first one second one
so do you have to tell orally or should we reply in the chat
reply in chat also orally also chat is good option because others can also try Yes, everyone has to try. These are the only four questions because we have seen book question also. These are four more questions.
So, is there nothing in the fourth one?
One second, I'm drawing. One second, I'm thinking about the diagram. One second.
Yeah, yeah. I think you left something for the fourth one.
So, these are four cases we have to see. We'll see one by one. How many zeros will be there?
Start applying.
0402 0 see number of zeros in first case
zero
is you are saying okay zero for Sara Tanzila Yudhav everyone is saying zero for this one five means this we can have x axis 1 2, 3, 4, 5. This one 5, okay? For third one, 0. Again 0. It's because 0, okay? Fourth one again?
2.
2, sir.
Okay, 1 and 2. So everybody is agreeing.
Can there be any graph like this, the fourth one? Because it's not continuous in range, right? So it would not be a continuous graph. It's not possible, right?
See, graph can be possible, but see, graph we have this. Na? We have seen in one doubt we had for hyperbola. So hyperbola graph is this one, this, like this only. And
okay, got it, sir.
Based on that, now we can find zeros of, but this graph, where basic concepts will be same. Okay, graph. It, where this you know, meeting at x-axis where this graph is intersecting cutting the x-axis so everybody is having same answer or anybody having different answer then these values same answer all of you are having same values okay fine so let me now see 1 second so for this one is correct because no other changes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So basically, this is cutting this axis 5 points. 5 is correct. Here also no change. 1, 2. So 2 is correct. For these two graphs, we'll see now. Okay, where this? For this one, we'll see first. For this one, see this is basically straight line. We can normally we can observe this is straight line. And a straight line we can line. Line means we can extend to at any positions. Line basically this is not finite fixed line, we can extend to both directions. So this will cut at one point. So number of solutions will be one, because line means we can extend in both the directions. So this can be given basically not complete line, or we can say this way line at some positions will cut this x-axis at after some, but this time we can extend in both directions. So this will cut x-axis at one point. Line basically degree one. So solution will be, see, always solution will be one. For straight line, any equations are there. Suppose straight line is y is equal to general equation x plus b. For this is for degree one, linear equation LE, and y equal to, always you have to remember, x square plus bx plus c, always is quadratic equation. So for linear equation, for any value of this now, any value of any value for one, say finite value, will get one solution, one zero, because y zero, we have to put basically. So y zero means in this equation zero will be equal to x plus b, and x will be equal to similarly minus b by a, simple equation, simple solving, minus b by a always. So always we'll get some finite value always. So a straight line will definitely will always be having one solution, one zero. So this we can extend in both directions. So solutions will be one, or we can say zero will be one, because line we can extend in both directions, and always we'll get zero value. Means for some value of x, definitely this now bx or y will be zero. It's a real solution we'll definitely get. Real solutions we can say, or roots value, or we can say zeros of this linear equation, linear polynomial. Because x is one, so only one solution or one zero will get. Get portion of 0 will be minus b by a. So definitely will extend, we can extend in both the directions, and it will cut at this x-axis. Okay, now we'll see for this graph. So say for this graph, if we normally observe, this is not, we can say, complete graph. So we can say for this graph 0 is also correct, and if nothing is there, because graph, we can say equation is also not given, and graph is not complete basically. Because suppose graph nature we know, suppose, let me know the, suppose if we change the graph like this, suppose this is the, this one was the graph like this, somewhat like this, smoothly we have to draw. So we can easily say zeros will be now one, because graph will similar fashion, it will extend, it can extend in both the directions. So at some point it will cut this x-axis. So in this case, for this graph, we can say number of zeros will be one, because see, this now graph nature will follow in most of the cases. So graph will at some point will cut the x-axis. If you open the this now in book also, if you can easily notice this fact, because graph will follow the pattern. So this will at some, after some period of time or after some locations, so this will cut this x-axis at only one portion. We can say number of zeros will be one. For this 2, 5, 1 is correct. For this case, because line we can extend. If you see the book also, no, we'll observe this one. We can extend line, we can extend in both directions, but zero is correct, because graph will not cut x-axis if you extend in both directions. This also we can extend. Second case, extend this one. So no extra values, only one solution, only one zero. We can extend in both directions. Our graph pattern will be same. It will extend, it can be extended in both directions based on the graph nature. So this will 1, 2, 3, no other change. Here we can extend, please extend. So this will be the extended portion of the graph. So again, only two values. Based on extension, we didn't get any extra value. So only two zeros. We can extend, suppose. So again, no extra value, only four solutions. Here also same thing. So only three, whatever the initial was the value. If we extend both the directions, so no other extra value we are getting, because graph nature is like this. Here also, if we extend in the example case, so same answer. Extend in both directions, so only one zero. Extend in both the directions, only two zeros, whatever was the initial value. Extend in both directions, no extra value, three, what was earlier. Extend in both directions, this was line, we can extend, but here also only one. So line has only one zero, or we can say only one root. Here we can extend, so no other change, only one solution. Extend, no other, no different answer basically. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 0. Similarly, for our case, we can extend in both the directions. For this case, we'll get one. If the graph is this one, we can say the zeros will be one. And for second, third, this one, for this, both the cases are correct. This one is correct. 5, 2 is correct. 1, again 1. Got it? So we've seen extension for our this NCERT book question also. But there are no change, because graph nature was such that after extending the graph in both the directions, in both the ways, we are not getting any extra values. But here we can say we will get one root, 1, 0, here 1, 0, based on the graph nature. Now we'll see some more cases we can say. See, now we'll see. Third one was zeros of polynomial based on the graph and equations. Now fourth one will be, fourth case we'll see now, that will be relation of zeros and this now coefficients of this equation. So suppose px is x square plus bx plus c. Always we write in bracket a not equal to zero, because this is basic condition for any quadratic polynomial. Okay, Udhav, you can leave the session because you have another session. No problem. Because actually 7 to 8 is our standard time. So, fine, no problem. So, px is x square plus bx plus c, a not equal to 0. So, zeros we can write. Zeros basically are 2 in this case, because degree is 2. So, we can represent zeros by alpha and beta. We can represent zeros by alpha and beta. And we have one quadratic formula. What is quadratic formula? By quadratic formula also we can find the zeros value. By quadratic formula also we can find zero value. X will be equal to minus b plus minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. This is basically, we have quadratic formula where capital D is discriminant value. Discriminant, that is equal to b square minus 4ac root. B square minus 4ac only, root is not there. B square minus 4ac. B square minus 4ac. B square minus 4ac. And alpha will be equal to, one value we can take alpha. Alpha is minus b. Plus value we can take plus b square minus 4ac by 2a. And beta another root, another zeros of this px, because degree is 2, x square is there, and that means degree is 2. So two solutions will get basically two values of x. So one value we can say as alpha, another value we can assume as beta. So beta will be minus b minus under root b square minus 4ac by 2a. My question is, what is the value of alpha plus beta? So alpha plus beta, we have seen, if you do addition, then this minus b plus under root b square minus 4ac by 2a plus minus b minus under root b square minus 4ac by 2a. We can check here. We can take LCM 2a. We can take LCM 2a. Solve along with me. We can take LCM 2a. And this will be minus b plus under root b square minus 4ac plus minus minus b plus minus minus b minus under root b square minus 4ac. Cancel. So this will be basically minus b minus b minus b minus 2b by 2a. 2 cancel. So basically alpha plus beta will be equal to minus b by a. Alpha plus beta will be equal to b by a minus b by a basically minus b by a. What is alpha into beta?
Alpha beta equals to c by a.
C by a.
C by a. Okay. So can we found by proper equation, like say alpha plus beta we have seen by solving alpha and beta value. One value will take alpha because plus minus is there. So plus value we can assume as alpha, minus value beta. So alpha plus beta we have seen minus b by a. This is one result we got. And then we can take other values. Let me write. So alpha plus beta is minus b by a. Now we have to see for alpha into beta. So alpha into beta will solve. Alpha into beta will be minus b plus under root b square minus 4ac by 2a. This is alpha into means dot, or we can write multiplication sign, minus b minus under root b square minus 4ac by 2a value. So basically we can see here, this is minus b same value, this is same value, b square minus 4ac, b square minus 4ac. So we can say this is in form of a plus b, a minus b, a plus b, a plus b, a minus b, because here we have plus sign and here minus sign. Basically a square minus b square. So minus b square plus minus minus plus minus minus, and this is square means root will be cancelled out because minus b is a first term a, that is minus b square, and then this now root will be removed because we are doing root of b square minus 4ac square. So b square minus 4ac will be there. 2a into 2a, 2a into 2a na, multiplication is here, so that is 4a square. So we can write the values now, b square minus b square, then minus minus plus 4ac by 4a square. B square cancel, and then this value will be 4ac by 4a square. 4a, 4a cancel, a cancel, this will be c by a. Hence we got this alpha into beta as c by a. Alpha into beta equal to c by a. This is the one value. This product of root will be c by a. Please note it down. We have
noted, sir.
Noted. Others also please note. Alpha beta is c by a, and alpha plus beta is minus b by a. Okay. Suppose my one last question, then we'll see in next session. Means next session will be again, will be on, okay, next Wednesday. Fine. Tomorrow will be a math, Vedic maths. Fine, no problem. One, see, Wednesday session was, couldn't happen, no? Wednesday session, one session. The one session for this one also will extend in next week, most probably. For this maths, one session is pending. So last question for today, see. Suppose my question is, if alpha and beta are given, so what will be the equation of the basically quadratic polynomial? Okay, Samarth, quadratic polynomial.
It will be x square plus or minus. It will be minus. X square minus alpha plus beta into x, whole into x.
Okay.
Plus
alpha beta. This is,
yeah,
dx value.
Yeah.
Okay, see. So correct. See, we can see here easily how we can obtain the equation. See, px is basically x square plus bx plus c. Px means any quadratic polynomial. Px is any quadratic polynomial. This is the standard formula, we can say standard form, x square plus bx plus c. Now suppose alpha beta is given, so if px is 0, So this equation becomes x square plus bx plus c zero. This we can say as QE. QE means quadratic equation. Quadratic equation it will become. And for this quadratic equation, we know alpha plus beta is minus b by a, and alpha beta we have just found this is c by a. C by a, correct. Alpha plus beta minus b by a. Alpha beta c by a. Suppose let me write the equation x square minus alpha plus beta. Suppose if we divide this equation by a, you can easily see, because a is there in alpha plus beta also, and alpha into beta also. Suppose we divide this equation, means x square plus bx plus c equal to zero. We can divide with a because we know this now a not equal to zero for this quadratic this now polynomial or quadratic equation, because a zero, so this term will become zero. So this equation will not be not remaining quadratic. This will become linear equation. That means a is not equal to zero. So we can divide throughout by a. So this will become x square, or we can say ax square by a plus bx by a plus c by a equal to zero. Why we have divided with a? Because we can see in alpha plus beta we have value minus b by a. Alpha beta also c by a, means a is in denominator side. So we can divide by a both the sides. So zero by a will be zero itself. So a by a will cancel out, x square plus b by a x plus c by a. Zero by zero. Now we can write this now b by a value here. From here this now b by a will equal to minus of alpha plus beta, and from here we can write c by a value alpha into beta. So we can write in terms of some alpha beta is given, so we can write in terms of alpha and beta. So we got this value x square beta b by a will be minus of alpha plus beta x, and c by a will be alpha beta equal to zero. This is basically we have quadratic equation. Because px is zero, that's when px is zero, then only we got alpha beta value. When px was zero, means y is zero, then only by solving that equation we got this alpha beta two roots. Because quadratic equation we know we have two roots, x1 and x2, or alpha and beta. Please note this one. Any doubt, anyone? Because now say
no sir, no.
Because a we can divide, and this will be x square plus b by x and plus c by a. B by a and c by a we can write in terms of alpha beta. So b by a will be minus of alpha plus beta, and c by a will be alpha beta. So we can put those values to get the equation in terms of alpha and beta. So x square, basically quadratic equation we got x square minus alpha plus beta x plus alpha beta equal to zero. This we can write in this manner also. X square minus alpha beta is sum of roots, because roots value are alpha and beta, sum of roots into x, plus we can write here product of roots, because alpha and beta are product of roots. Alpha beta roots value, so product of roots equal to zero. X square minus sum of roots into x plus product of roots equal to zero is the required quadratic equation in degree 2. Alpha and beta are given, so we can write the value of alpha plus beta and alpha into beta. So please note this one, and those who have doubt that they can stay back, otherwise after noting you all can log out or end the session.
Okay sir, thank you sir.
Thank you so much.
Thank you sir.
Thank you Steve. Thank you Zivian. Anyone having doubt that they can stay back and ask the doubt. I will repeat one second. For all the sessions, for all basic concept or anyone, anything you want to ask me, please ask.
Sir, could you like tell what happened at the start? I was not there.
Okay. See, in the start, we have just now revised those topics which we have already completed. See, polynomials means nominals means terms. So based on the number of terms now we have studied, type of polynomials, types of polynomials based on number of terms. Monomial we know. Mono means one and nominal means term, so one term. Bi means two, and nominal means term, two terms we know. Tri means three, nominal means again term. So three terms are called as trinomials. Quadrinomials, quadri means four and nominal means term. Four terms, any equation, any polynomial having four terms is called as quadrinomial. Any equation, any polynomial having three terms, that is called as trinomial, then similarly binomial and monomial. All these now we have seen in your previous session, and in detail now you can download those previous session PDF and or recordings. You can go through to, we have number of examples we have seen. Then second was types of polynomial based on degree. Degree means power, degree means maximum power of x. Degree means maximum power of x. This we have seen. So
right.
Linear means one, quadratic means degree two. Degree two means power of x will be maximum power of x will be two. Cubic means three maximum power. Bi means two. Quadratic again two to fourth degree. We can say correct. So this will be four, having 4 degree. So these are the 4 cases. And zeros, then we have seen the number of zeros we will find based on the equation of polynomial. Px is zero, then x will be equal to minus two. Suppose we have quadratic polynomial, then we can simplify the equation based on splitting middle term. We get 2 zeros means 2x values, 2 and 1. So these 2 values are called as zeros of Px. That means Px is zero at these two positions, at these 2 values of x. Any other doubt? These basics only we revised in first few minutes.
Sir, what was the formula for the cubic graph?
For cubic, we'll see in our next session. For cubic, suppose, let me write here. For cubic polynomial, this is the standard form. Px equal to, similar to quadratic polynomial, x cube, this will be x cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, where a not equal to zero. One more term, one more constant will be added, that is d. In quadratic we had ax square plus bx plus c, where a not equal to zero. In cubic, standard equation will be x cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, a not equal to zero again, because suppose this is a zero, so this term will be zero, and this whole thing will be converted to quadratic, not cubic. That we'll see in detail in our next session.
Okay. So, sir, that was it, right?
So, Sara, your doubt is polynomial can be defined as, see, polynomial means having equation in which now power of x are non-negative. This now non-negative integers. You can say polynomials we can define as equation in which this we have seen in our first session only, in which powers of x are non-negative, matlab basically positive value, zero can also be there, zero and then more than zero, non-negative integers. This will be polynomials. So polynomials are equations in which powers of x are non-negative integers. Non-negative means not negative values, basically not -1, not -2, not in fraction also. Integers means proper values, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, these are integer values. And non-negative means zero and more than zero, zero or more than zero. That is basically, you can say, definition or this is the criteria for polynomial. So any equation in which this now x power of x are non-negative integers, we can say as polynomial. Suppose one example, px is x plus 1 by x. This is polynomial or not, Sarah? This will be not a polynomial. Why? Because here we can write, this is x and plus x to the power minus 1. This is power 1, but this is minus 1. Minus 1 will not be the power of, minus 1 should not be power of x. Clearly we know polynomials are equations in terms of x in which powers of x are non-negative integer. Non-negative means zero or more than zero, and integer value we know. Integer is represented by, we can say, z or I, and these are the integer set value, plus, comma, 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 minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, dot, 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 so on. So basically not in fraction, integer value. Minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And here they we know non-negative. Non-negative is 0 or more than 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will work. So x to a minus 1 will not be, it will not be a valid polynomial. So it will not be an equation of polynomial. So one more equation, p px is given. So x plus x root, this will be polynomial? No, again no, because this is one value, correct? And this will be power 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is fraction. Fraction power of x will not be allowed because we have non-negative integer. Non-negative, 1 by 2 is non-negative, but it is not integer value. Integer means it should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this, not in fraction. So this will not be a polynomial. So polynomial, we can say polynomial is any equation in terms of x where powers of x are non-negative integers. Powers of x are non-negative. These three words we have to remember, non-negative integers. Non-negative means zero. Zero we can take zero or more than zero, and it will be integer value, not decimal or fraction. Integer means proper. We can see, we know the integer sets. From zero, we have to take. Integer is basically minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, any value. But here in this case, polynomial, we have to take non-negative integers, means zero and value more than zero. Got it? Find any doubt? Okay, fine. So you can now this now log out from the session. I'm also ending this from my side. Okay. Thank you for attending.